This video shows you how to get started using the DevExpress .NET MAUI editors. We'll build simple login and signup forms with the combobox, a masked input, text edits, password editors, chips, and checkbox. After the basic setup, we'll specify an editor's mask, add a few input validation rules, and customize the editor appearance. Before we begin, we recommend you review the video on how to use our NuGet gallery to incorporate our controls into your .NET MAUI application, or review the Get Started section in the documentation. For this video, we're also going to assume that you have the latest version of Visual Studio 22 Preview installed with all required workloads. If you're not familiar with the .NET MAUI framework, please review Microsoft documentation on how to start using this platform. Okay, let's get started. We'll start with creating a new .NET MAUI application using the DevExpress templates. In this sample, we need the data editors. Pick this option and click Create. Create a new View Models folder and then the base View Model class. This class implements the iNotifyPropertyChanged interface and contains the PropertyChanged event handler, setProperty method, and onPropertyChanged event handler. Now we can create the base view model's login view model descendant class. We'll populate the login view model class with the fields that will be used in our login view page. Let's add the login and password properties. Now we'll create our view. Create a new folder and name it views. Create a new page that's called Login View and place it in the Views folder. Open the LoginView.xaml and add a standard label, our text edit, password edit, and two simple buttons. Bind our editor's text properties to the properties of our Login View model. We'll also specify label text and placeholder text properties for our editors and button captions. The first button is the login button, and the second is the signup button. The signup button will switch our view to the signup view. In the loginview.xaml.cs, create a new login view model instance and set the binding context property to that instance. Now we need to create an app shell. This element contains views that should be displayed in the application. Create the new content page and change its XAML content as described. Now we can remove the mainpage.xaml file since our views are specified in the appshell.xaml file. In the app.xaml.cs file, register a new route to our login view. Now we can run the application to see what we've got. You can display an editor's icon using the start icon property. Let's specify the icon for the text edit and password box edit. In your project, create the images folder and place the icon in this folder. In the loginview.xaml file, set the start icon property to names of your icons. Now we'll create the signup view that will contain text, password, date, combo box, multi-line, check edits, input chip group, and simple button DevExpress classes. Create a new page, call it signup view, and place it in the views folder. Let's add our editors to the signupview.xaml file and specify their text, label text, help text, and placeholder text properties. We should also create the signup view model class. That is the base view model descendant, and place the signupviewmodel.cs file in the view models folder. Add properties to the signupviewmode.cs file. These properties are used to store values that are displayed in our signup view. In our solution, create the model folder. Create the chip data object and country code classes and place them in the model folder. The chip data object class defines the data fields of a chip item. The country code class defines fields of the country items. Country items include a country name and a country code. Open the appshell.xaml file and add the view that we've created. In the app.xaml.cs file, we should register the created route. Open the loginview.xaml file and set the signup simple buttons command property to the created command. Now, open the loginviewmodel.cs file and create a new command that will switch our application views. Open the signupview.xaml.cs and create the methods that are called when the login and password editor's values are changed. These methods will run the validation operation that we're going to define in our view model. Now we can run our application. Click the signup button to switch to the signup view. Let's fill these editors with values. And note that when we select a country in the combo box, the country code is automatically specified in the phone editor. DevExpress.NET MAUI data editors include APIs that allow you to implement validation. Let's add the value validation for our text and password editors on the signup view page. Open the signup view view model and add the login has error and password has error Boolean properties. These methods will run the validation operation that we are going to define in our view model. Go back to the signupview.xaml and bind the hasError property for both of these controls to the properties that we've created in the view model. These properties indicate whether the bound data editors contain an error. You can also specify the error text property that is in the text written in the editor when the editor's property is not valid. Add the property changed event handlers for the login and password editors. Run the application to see the result. In this application, we also validate the login view editor's values and enable the login button only when the values of these editors are valid. Open the login view view model and add the login has error and password has error Boolean properties. Just like in the previous step, these properties indicate whether the bound data editors contain an error. Add the text changed event handlers for the login and password editors. And bind the hasError property for both of these controls to the properties that we've created in the view model. Run the application to see the result. DevExpress.NET MAUI editors allow you to change the appearance of the specified editor or of all the editors of a given type. For the latter case, you can use the styles.xaml file that is located in the Resources Styles folder. To change the application's header appearance, create the Styles folder inside Resources, create the colors.xaml, and specify your custom colors there. Let's specify custom colors for our simple button, text edit, password box, combo box edit, multi-line edit, and check edit. In the styles folder, create the style.xaml and specify custom appearance that are applied to all controls of the given type. Now open the app.xaml file and specify a link to our colors and styles.xaml files to apply their custom appearance settings to the application. And set our application header style to our custom style. You can also use the keyboard property to specify a keyboard type that should be used to input the editor's value. Now let's take a look at our application. You can also explore the data editors in our demo application. A link to the repository is available in the description below. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.